टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द साइज ऑफ बियर्ड. व्हाट शुड बी द साइज ऑफ बियर्ड? एंड बिकॉज देर इज़ क्वेश्चन इन द माइंड ऑफ द पीपल दैट हाउ मैनी और हाउ मच साइज बिगर शुड बी द यूज हैंडफुल साइज ऑफ बियर्ड. सम पीपल हैव द बियर्ड साइज लाइक टिल the belly. Some people like just small size, just finger size. Some people have used to keep the beard like a half of the finger. So what is the real size according to the Quran and Hadith? Today inshallah we will discuss about it. So first of all, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, awfirul luha wahshu shawarib, khaliful mushrikeen awfirul luha wahshu shawarib. Many hadith came, like Sahajit, almost all the books of 6 books came this hadith, increase and grow your beard size and cut down your mustache. So what is the logically reason behind this? Inshallah we will discuss after that. So first of all, this is the clear that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said grow the beard and cut off the mustache. So first of all, we have to see in the companions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the most close to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that was Hazrat Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu anhu. This is the companions, most authentic companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said that he has to catch his beard and then he has to cut downside like handful. He has almost for 10 years his action was this, like he has to catch his beard and then cut down from with scissor from the beard size. So this was the routine and the companions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So what was the size of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? This is question. Did Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam use to scissor to cut the beard or not? So the answer is this, that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by nature his beard was like a handful, but in hadith came that his beard used to full the chest size, like chest has. But Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam beard was by nature like handful size, by nature. Some people, there are some people that their beards hair don't grow more and more. So this is clear that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam also his beard was like a handful size. And he never used scissor or any kind of that kind of element to cut the beard. So similarly, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam also when we study in the historic background, so an Aisha radhiyallahu anhu qalat Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam asharatun min al-fitrati, 10 things are from nature. First of all, he should said that grow the beard size, grow the beard, cut, second thing, cut the mustache, and the third thing, cut the armpit hair, the fourth thing, cut the pubic hair, the fifth thing, to do istinja, use shower, like to use shower, and the fifth thing, like to cut the nail. And to do kulli mean like to enter the water into the mouth, then into the nose. So these are almost 10 things have been discussed, that they are from nature, like from first man of the history and till last man. So everyone uses this one. So this was that by nature. So that the hair to grow hair, hair of beard, it is from nature, and to cut the mustache is also from nature. Similarly, we find historically an event that the Holy Quran also has discussed لا تأخذ بلحيتي ولا برأسي إني خشيت أن تقول. So Prophet Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, when he went to Koh Tur, the mountain of Tur, with the order of Allah Almighty to take the Torah, to take his book from here, so he spent here 40 days. So he remained here 40 days. So when he came back, the whole his community and nation started to pray, to worship a cow. Cow worship it started from this point. And when he came back, because his prophet of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam was his elder brother, Prophet Harun alayhi salam. Prophet Harun was his elder brother. He was the wise prophet of Prophet Musa, after Prophet Musa. So when Prophet Musa alayhi salatu wasalam saw that the whole nation and community was inclining and worshipping before a cow, so he, first of all, he came here, he came to his brother and started to catch his beard. So why you did not prohibit, you did not forbid them? So they are worshipping to a cow, they are bowing to before a cow. What, why is this? So he said, لا تأخذ بلحيتي. Oh my brother, the son of my mother, please don't catch my beard, because I forbade them, but they did not follow to me. So these were the sayings and these were the talks of Prophet Harun alayhi salatu wasalam when Prophet Musa alayhi salatu wasalam used to catch. So this also shows that Mufassirin says, scholars say that the size of Prophet Harun alayhi salatu wasalam, the beard size was like the handful size. So this is the reason that Prophet Musa alayhi salatu wasalam was unable to catch the beard. So this was the what is the logical reasoning and what is the benefit of beard. So multiple scholars say that beard, when we keep beard, this is very very good thing for our skin, for our face, for our other problem. This is the solution of many kind of problem. So what is the reason behind to cut the mustache? Because we cut the mustache, this is the order by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, many hadith. So what was the reason behind this? So the reason is this, that when we take breath, so we the oxygen enters in our belly, in our stomach. So when we bring out that so the oxygen converts into the carbon dioxide. So when carbon dioxide goes out from our body, so this from this uses so carbon dioxide matches and meets with the hair of the mustache. So when it meets with the hair of mustache, so then we take water, we drink water, we take another liquid. So with the with the amalgamation of liquid, so the carbon dioxide again enter in our belly and stomach. This is dangerous for our health. So there are multiple also other reason that we should cut down the mustache. So this was about the size of lihya. This is the Arabic word that is called beard. So we should grow the beard size, and we also discussed that this should be handful according to the companions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's action was also like this. So this is also another question, that why Egyptian people do not keep beard? What was the reason? So first of all, the answer is this. First of all, there is issue of license. They had to take license for growing the beard size. So second thing, like there is not permitted, this is prohibited officially. The second thing is this, that there are concept and understanding among the Egyptian scholar and people that it is not necessary. It is just optional thing. So as I told you that it is compulsory because Prophet Muhammad ordered in many hadith that to grow the beard. And Prophet Muhammad himself size as well as the companions of Prophet Muhammad beard size was like this. So some people say that this is not compulsory, this is just optional thing. And first Prophet Muhammad like miswak like toothbrush, Prophet Muhammad used this one many times. This was optional, and Prophet Muhammad continuously did this one, continuously used miswak. So what is this is optional thing? So the answer is this, that Prophet, there was a companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He has just one hair in his beard. So once he understood that this is one hair, so I should cut this one. So he cut the one hair. So he came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam turned his face from this person. Then the person came to other side where the face of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam also turned his face from other side toward other side. So he understood that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam angered because of my action, that I cut one hair of my beard. That was just only one hair. So this shows that we should grow, we should keep hair beard, we should grow this one. This is compulsory and this is not optional, like prayer. This is optional, not optional, but this is compulsory thing.